Compare and describe the characteristics of rational and irrational numbers.
Are all numbers either rational or irrational?
Well, all real numbers are either rational or irrational. Let's look at the relationships and the hierarchy of the real numbers. Natural numbers were the first numbers you learned, the counting numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Add 0 and you have the whole numbers. Add the negative integers to the whole numbers and you have the set of integers. Since every integer has an understood denominator of 1, the integers are a subset of fractions, or the rational numbers. Adding irrational numbers with the rational numbers completes the hierarchy of real numbers, which are the numbers you encounter in introductory algebra.
What's the difference between a rational and irrational number?
First, let's define a rational number. The root of rational is ratio. As invented by the ancient Greeks, a rational number is any real number that can be written or expressed as the ratio of two integers, in other words, a fraction. An irrational number is any real number that cannot be written or expressed as the ratio of two integers.
If rational numbers are fractions, how are irrational numbers expressed?
Well, let's first look at the expression of rational numbers as fractions and decimals. Notice the decimals terminate. In other words, at some point, the decimal part stops. The irrational numbers expressed as decimals do not stop. The three dots or ellipses at the end indicate they are non-terminating. However, there's one exception to this pattern. Consider the fraction 1/3. It's the ratio of two integers, so it's a rational number. Its decimal representation is decimal 333333 and so on. In other words, it is non-terminating. The fraction 113 divided by 333 can also be represented as a non-terminating decimal. However, both decimals either repeat a single digit or the same three digits in a repeating block. Compare the non-terminating decimals of the irrational numbers. They neither repeat the same digit nor group of digits. Use the following rule when comparing decimals. Decimals that terminate or repeat are rational numbers. Decimals that do not terminate or repeat are irrational.
Are all irrational numbers non-terminating and non-repeating decimals?
Yes, if written as a decimal. But there are other representations of irrational numbers. Consider the square root of 4, or the square root of 100. Both are equivalent to integers. The square root of 4 is 2, and 2 can be written as 2 divided by 1, so it is a rational number. In the same way, the square root of 100 can be expressed as 10 divided by 1, so it is also rational. What about the square root of 2 or the square root of 125? Neither of these can be written as an integer or the ratio of two integers. Quite often, the decimal approximation of these numbers is listed in the manner you see here. But neither of these decimal values terminates nor repeats. These types of real numbers, square roots of non-perfect squares, are also irrational numbers. Finally, some special irrational numbers are uniquely represented.
What does that mean?
It means they have their own notation. For example, pi is a special irrational number, the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its diameter. Often, the value of pi is rounded to 3.14 or even 3.14159, and sometimes approximated to 22 divided by 7. Its numerical representation is actually a decimal that never repeats and never terminates. Thus, it is an irrational number. Another example is e. Its numerical decimal value never repeats or terminates. Irrational numbers like these are important in real-world applications of banking, growth and decay models, computer testing, and architecture.